When Uncle Ike, when Ian Eisenberg first showed up in the neighborhood, he thought he could intimidate people with his size and with his money. We had banners up on the fence over there at East 23rd and East Union for the Emoji Fest, and his weirdo ass came over there ripping them down. He got confronted, and listen to this real quickly, folks. He got confronted by not only black people, but anarchists. They told him what time it was.
Damn right we did.
They told him, you don't come in a black neighborhood and start throwing your weight around. Okay. Especially when you're coming from Israel.
Oh, you guys, you got it.
And your former IDF. We're not doing that. Okay, the Vanguard's here, all right? You understand? We got the red, black, and green in your face, okay? Muammar Gaddafi, Minister Farrakhan, and listen. No investigation, no right to speak. I'm from here. Understand me. Those three started the worldwide anti-Zionist, okay? And they were hating on when they came to this town. This guy here comes in here, and he's just loved because he's the pot guy. Let's talk about how recreational marijuana destroyed the medical side of things. How many patients out here? How many medical patients?
Yeah.
Terminal illness type people, okay? He's part of that regime that went ahead and changed that up and made it worse for everybody. Okay, I'm whipping around here. I'm a patient too. Here I am, okay? My message to Eisenberg, you keep your hands off Amari or someone's going to come see you, all right? No, really. We ain't playing out here. We've been seizing buildings. We've been dealing with reactionary crackers like yourself. We've been dealing with these cops for many, many years. Omari's been here since the late 40s, okay? He's seen as a senior active, as an elder and leader up in here, and that's who you gotta deal with, and you gotta deal with all of his soldiers out here as well. Give me a what's up if you guys are the soldiers for Omari out here. Let me hear what it do if you're a soldier for Big O out here.
What it do?
Because that's what time it is, okay? You're not just dealing with the rabble, you're dealing with the astute, the intelligent people, okay? And as long as you're going to be in this neighborhood, you're going to do as you're told.
Yep. So, we want to make it clear to everyone here, why are we here?
Black Lives Matter!
You see, Uncle Ike is no uncle of mine. You see, Uncle Ike came into this predominantly black neighborhood, or what it was left of it, because we've been pushed out, and they decided to not only buy up 23rd and Union, yeah, that's right, they not only own this area, they also own those gentrifying apartments over there. Yeah, that's our Uncle Ike.
Yeah, fuck those apartments!
You see, he came in here and started buying up our land. Now let me tell you something, in the 80s, the black neighborhood was almost 80% Central District. And you know why? Because this was a segregated neighborhood. And it was the only place they allowed us to live. And now, they aren't even allowing us to live in Seattle. They're pushing us to Renton, Federal Way, Tacoma. And Uncle Ike is just another pink in the system perpetuating white supremacy. He not only bought up our corner, 23rd and Union, where countless young black people have gone to jail and are still in jail for selling marijuana. He came in here and started profiting off of what was once our business, on what was once our block. One last thing I want to say is that right next door we have one of the last black churches. And they begged for Uncle Ike not to put this pot shop next to their church. Because not only is it a church, but they have a preschool, and you're not allowed to put pot shops in front of preschools. But no one listened. Because Uncle Ike has got money. That's why he can do things like that.